Now, I know that processors are one of the most important components of a laptop or a desktop, and I think Intel ones are the most popular at the moment, but there's just so many to choose from, loads of different ranges and model numbers. What sort of processor should I go for?
To start with, we have to explain how confusing it is. And I think with Intel processors, we look at the Core i family as the main example here. You have Core i3, i5, and i7, which appears to show least powerful to most powerful, right? However, it isn't quite that simple. i3, i5, i7 is purely a branding thing that tells you how good a processor is in its range. The four-digit number after the i3, i5, or i7 tells you how powerful that processor is in which generation. So the first number is the generation, and then the other three numbers will tell you how far up the range in that generation you are. So the higher those three numbers, the probably more powerful your processor is, with a few exceptions. And then at the end of that four-digit number is a letter or two letters.
Yes,
this is really confusing.
It is really confusing. I don't know how most people get on with this. So there are loads of different what we call suffixes. If you see a U at the end, this is a low power processor for fairly cheap or fairly thin laptops. If you see MQ or HQ, then you're looking at a small powerful processor in a more expensive laptop or even a gaming laptop. If you see a Y as the second digit, that is what used to be called a Core M chip.
So you're saying I could get an i7, which to me sounds powerful, but then it has a Y in the model number, which means it's what was formerly a mobile chip, therefore it won't be that powerful.
Indeed, yeah, a Core i7 7Y75 will be less powerful than a Core i5 6500 MQ, for example.
So what we've talked about so far are for laptop processors. Is it the same for desktops?
Kind of, although laptop versus desktop Intel Core i chips, they are quite different in terms of features. Desktop chips either have no suffix, so i5 6500, for example, or a K suffix, i5 6600K, which denotes an overclockable chip that you can increase the clock speed of.
Now let's talk about cores, because you can get dual core, quad core, octa core. Where should I start with the number of cores in my processors?
So Intel's processors right now, they're either dual core or quad core, but it's not, again, quite that simple. Many of them will come with what's called hyperthreading, and this is a technique to split each core into two separate threads, which allows the operating system to use the cores more efficiently. And you end up with what your PC sees as 8 cores on a 4-core chip with hyperthreading. It doesn't double your performance, it increases it by roughly a third.
So I guess that would be most useful if I'm a sort of video editor or a gamer or something?
Pretty much, yeah. If you're running multiple tasks or doing rendering operations and things like that, yes, that's very important. For everybody else, it's less so.
Now, if it's not confusing enough already, should we have a quick chat about core speeds and clock speeds? How does that all work?
Yeah, core speed is actually the simplest way, if all else fails, the simplest way of seeing how powerful your laptop is. All of the things we've just talked about, the lowest end processors have the lowest clock speed and the highest end ones have the highest clock speed. And that's basically it.
That makes sense.
This is how you can tell that a very thin and light laptop will be less powerful than a similarly priced gaming laptop because it has a lower core clock speed.
So can you give me an example if I'm going to go into a shop and buy a fairly sort of cheap low-end laptop, maybe that's something good for streaming, for a bit of office work. What sort of processor should I be getting from that?
You'll probably see most of those budget laptops will have a U suffix, so Core i3, 6100U, etc.
And if I'm going to buy something more like a multimedia machine, something for more a bit more of light gaming or something, what would you recommend for that?
Yeah, you'll see things like MQ suffixes and HQ as well. You can get an HQ processor in the Dell XPS 15, for example, which is actually really impressive. Very thin laptop with a pretty high-end processor.
And what about gaming laptops? Is there anything I should look specifically for those?
Again, you'll probably see HQ suffix processors. You might also see HK, which come in the ultra expensive, gigantic gaming laptops that you can overclock.
Well, that's clear things up for me. Thank you very much, Michael. And if you want to find out more, you can check out our full article on trustreviews.com.